Good day, students. Today we are going to start with another unit, another session of unit 1, which is digital documentation advanced. And in our last class we had learned about how to create templates in a digital document. Today we are going to learn a new session which is called creating of table of content, creating and customizing table of content. Now what is a table of content? Now suppose you have a document which has got a lot of matter in your document, say 200-300 pages, and this particular document is divided into different chapters, and those chapters are further divided into different sections and units, and under those different sections we have got different subsections and subheadings and subheadings. Now at the end of making a 200-300 page document, you want to make an index of the total matter, that is an index or a gist of the entire document. Now using these headings and subheadings, we can create an index or a table of content of a particular document in a very easy way with the help of this feature in digital documentation. We can also customize this particular table of content according to our needs. That is, exactly it will tell you that each heading or each particular part on which page number it is, and if you want to have a direct hyperlink between into those particular places, we can also insert such hyperlinks along with the table of content. So that is what we are going to learn under this unit or under this session called customizing and creating and customizing table of content. So let us go into how to create it. Table of content is nothing but an index which we create for the contents of our document. Generally, indexes are placed before the document so that a user can understand what is the content which is present in a document. That is, what are the topics, on which page numbers they are, what are the different types of subtopics which are there, how many chapters are there in a particular book or a document or a report. All this type of information we get at a glance by looking at an index or a table of content. So now we are going to understand how to create this table of content. But before that, we have to first look at this particular example which I have already created for you, this particular document which is a document on pollution. Now here I have divided this topic into three different chapters. So chapter 1 is pollution and its types, chapter 2 is effects of pollution, and chapter number 3 I have put it as long term and short term effects. Now here under the chapter number 1 I have further divided into introduction, types of pollutions, under which we have got land, water, air, noise, light, etc. I have put similarly, I have in the chapter number 2 also has got an introduction and the effects on human, on animals, on effects on the animals, on environment, etc. Everything is the subtopics of this particular chapter. Similarly, on the similar lines, in the third one chapter I have got introduction as the first part and long-term and short-term effects. Now these are the different subtopics which are there. So if I want to include all the headings as well as the topics and subtopics which are included in this particular document, then before I start making a table of content, I have to first assign levels of headings to these particular topics. Now in the styles chapter, when I had taught you styles, I had already taught you about the different heading levels, the different content levels and different styles which I can assign to the contents of a document. So going on that similar lines, first we will select the first topic, that is chapter number 1, the heading of the topic, which here in the styles and headings formatting toolbar I will click on heading number 1. Now similarly, my chapter number 2 again will be heading number 1. The level is the same. So all of them will have the same font. See, I'll select it as heading number 1. Now here again select this again as heading number 1. Now there seems to be some issue with this. I'll just delete this. I'm writing it again.
chapter 1, pollution and its types. Now I select this, and this again is my chapter number 1. Okay, now here chapter number 2, let us go into the introduction is going to be my heading number 2. Here again, introduction to the effects is going to be my heading number 2, and once again over here, this introduction is also going to be my heading number 2. Similarly, the third one, that is the types of pollution, this is going to be my heading number 3. Here again, effects of pollution, this is also going to be my heading number 3. Here again, this is heading number 3, and this again will be my heading number 3. Here I go on to the next chapter. Here, short-term effects, this is my heading level 3, and this is my heading level 3. Now, the long-term effects. Now here, when I click on, I've got one more level over here. If I want to, I can put this also as my heading level number 4, that is the different types, that is land, etc. So if I want more, I can simply click here on more and double click on the level of heading. This here, we have got heading number 4. Once again over here, heading number 4. And this is also again heading number 4, I double click. So now here in this particular document, I have got 4 levels of headings, that is heading number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now I want to create a table of content. So I will, generally the table of content or the index is on the first page. So I just move this, I give space enough, I am moving this to the second page. Yes, now my page number 1 is completely empty. Here I am now on page number 1. I click on index and click on indexes and tables option and then click on index and table. Now when I click on this, automatically a dialog box will open up which will show me insert index and table. Now here it has got 5 different tabs which we will be learning in the course of this chapter. The first tab is called as the index and table tab, which is very important. Here it, as a, the preview is displayed to you on the left hand side. Now here, if I want, as of now, the title of content, table of content is the title. I can change this and I can write it to any other title that I want. Let us take, I'm giving it as pollution index. Okay, here now, the type of, on what type of table of content am I here? Now there are different types of table of content. In a document, I can have different headings. I can have different types of tables which I have created, or different types of objects which I have inserted. Like for example, picture 1, picture 2, picture 3, or maybe I have inserted some other different types of objects. So I can create a bibliography of the different types of meanings of particular words. All this type of contents I can create as a table of content, but here as of now I'm creating an index I can create for all these different objects in my document. But here as of now I'm just creating a table of content for the different headings that I have created. Now here, create an index for the entire document or for a particular chapter. Now if I want only for a particular chapter, for example I want only for chapter number 1, I can do that. Or here as of now I'm creating for the entire document which covers 3 chapters. Now the next one, evaluate up to how many levels. Now as of now, you remember we had done 4 levels of headings in our document, so I will evaluate up to 4 levels. Now this I can evaluate up to how many ever levels, like a sub level sub. So there are total 10 levels of headings which I can include in my document. Level of headings can be from 1 to 10. So the different styles of headings will be applicable. Now here, create from an outline. Now if I, this is the most important, I need to check this. This index mark is not needed here because it is some additional entry which I want, which I can put, which I don't need to right now. So I click on, I uncheck this. Now, as of now, my structure is ready. That means I have given the title, I have selected the type of index which I want, of the headings I wanted. I want it for the entire document, and the outline in this format I want it at different levels. That is, the higher level first, then below that, like this, in a descending order like this, I want the outline. And now when I click on OK, it will give me the table of content. See here, the first level is chapter number 1, chapter number 2, chapter number 3. The second level is introductions here. The third level is the type of pollution. Here I've got effects. This is the third one. And below this, the fourth level. So here, four levels of headings which I had defined, they have all come up into my table of content. So here, this way, now along with the table and the different heading topics, I have also got the page numbers on which they are. So all the page numbers are properly displayed on the right hand side. So this is how we can set up a table of content. Now, if I want to make any changes to this table of content, I have to go back to the same dialog box or the same window. So for that purpose, I click right click and click on edit, index and table. It will take me back to the same window where I can make the different changes possible. Now, one important change which I said was protects against manual change. Now here, suppose I want to make some changes over here, and instead of writing just on humans, I want to write it as human beings. But here it is not allowing me to make any changes to this because my protect against manual changes has been enabled. So it will not allow me to make. So suppose if I change this, and here now if I try to enter human being, it will allow me to make the change because I have unselected the protect against manual change. Now similarly, here I am showing four levels of the difference. That is first level, second level, third level and four. Now I am finding it a bit crowded over here, so I am not wanting to give this particular fourth level. So I can once again right click, edit, index and changes, again edit it, and here instead of evaluate up to four levels, I can say evaluate only up to three levels. So when I click here, it will show me only the three levels, the first level, second level and types. The fourth level of the air, water, etc. has got changed. So this is how I can make the change. Now an important matter is, suppose if I change or update this particular thing. For example, here this is on first page, second page. Now here this chapter number 2, I am shifting it, I press the enter key and I am shifting it to page number 4. Or page number 5. See, it has gone to page number 5. Now here again, this one is again, I'm shifting it a bit more up. I'm deleting the spaces over here and bringing it back here. So here, now my chapter number 3 is on page number 6, but my chapter number 2 is changed to page number 5. Now, when I go up here, I made some changes, but the change is not reflected automatically over here on this index and content table of content. So for updating any change, I need to right click and click on update index table. Now when I update, see, automatically all the page numbers which I got changed, it was changed from fifth to fourth to fifth page. So here, this way, here I am can make some changes. If I change it over to page number 2, this one is on page number 2, and here I'm deleting the spaces and bringing something back. So this is on page number 3. So I make any changes to this, I will have to update it. Right click, update the table of content. Now it has got updated automatically. So this way, I want to make some changes, I can do it and update the table. Now going on to this first tab, that is index and table tab, we've already learned how I can change the title, how I have to, I can change the type and for the entire document or for a particular chapter, and I can also, like chapter wise, if I want to give an index, I can also do that by clicking on the for the particular chapter. Then I can give this. Here also I told you how I can increase or decrease the level of evaluation of the heading. Now one important matter is here, additional style. What is the meaning of additional style? This particular option I'm going to explain to you. Now here in my document over here, I have got this particular hyperlink or this particular content which is neither a heading, but I want to, it is neither a heading, but it is simply a line or a document. But this particular hyperlink to website, I want to include it in my index, which can tell that there are some hyperlinks which are there. Now here, instead of giving it as a heading, I am giving it as a content. I am giving this style as content 1. But when I include, but because my title of content contains only headings, now what I can do is, I can index, and here under additional styles, I can click on this box and say that the content also I want to include, that content 1 which I gave, I can include it into different levels. Now suppose if I want to put it after the first level, second level, or the third level. After the third level or the fourth level, I want to put it as a fourth level, then the content 1, fourth level, I move it using this key and say OK. And then click on OK. Now here you will see the hyperlink, that particular option has also come up as my fourth level. That is a content which is not a heading, but a different style, an additional style which I had given, that can also be included into my content, table of content, by selecting the part called as additional style. So any new style, suppose if I have created, you remember we had created new styles in when we were learning styles, and that particular style also, that particular option, I want to put it into my table of content, that also I can do using additional styles. Now suppose if I don't want it, I want to remove it out, I don't want that, I can simply click on this and take it back again. I don't want the table of content, it in the table of content, the additional style, so it will go away automatically, that particular thing has gone away. So this is how I can include additional styles into the table. Now the next part, again I click on edit, insert. Here we have now covered almost all the different topics under the title, types, the for document, evaluate up to, and all this different topics. Now we go on to the, there are five different tabs. Today we are going to do only two simpler ones, one important one and two simple tabs, the column tab. Now, by default, the entire table of content is displayed in a single page. But what if I want, if the table of content is going into two or three pages and it's unnecessarily becoming a bit confusing, I can put it as two equal columns or three columns according to my wish. Now see, the entire table of content gets divided into two columns. Suppose if I want it, again click here, edit. I want it as three columns, then I can get it as three different columns depending upon the content. So this way I can divide my table of content into different columns. This is a very simple one. I'm just simply going back to one column. This is what is table of content. Now again I go back to edit, table of content. Let us go back to background. Very simple again here. I can select any background for the table of content to give it a different look. Again edit, go back to background, and I can select any light color, dark color as I want. So it can bifurcate it in a different color format. That is the color option here. Now, along with the color option, I also have under the background tab something called as a graphic option. Under the graphic option, I click on browse and I can select any of the image that I want as my background. So let's take, I have selected this image here. Now here it can be position. Now here there are different type position. Now in position I can select how I want, where I want. Suppose I want it on the top right, so it will be, this particular image will come on the top right. Again index, go back. Now suppose if I want it over here at the bottom, then it comes over here in the bottom right of the table. Similarly, if I want, so this is the position, so whichever position I place my point at, that position, that image will come. Suppose if I click on area, then it will come here right as an entire, on the entire table of content, that image will get spread. Similarly, right click again here, tiles. If I put it as a tile, then the same image will come as a tile option in this, under as a background of the table of content. So this way I have got three different options, graphic option, and under the graphic option I have got position, area and tile, or I can simply go and give a plain color to my background of the table of content. This is what is called as table of content. And today's chapter, in today's class, we have learned three different tabs. That is, first we learned how to give the different levels of headings, then how we created using the index tab we created the content, table of content, and also we learned how to use the different options which are available under the index and table tab. We learned the column tab and the background tab. In our next class, we are going to learn two other tabs, which are the entries and the styles tab. So here in our chapter on creating and customizing in table of content, we have learned how to use the insert tab and how to insert, how to give the different levels of headings like heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, etc. Then how to insert the table of content using the insert tab, how to update it by double click, by when we can update it, and also we learned the index and table dialog box. We learned how to use it, how to set the different types of attributes, that is the type, the entire document, outline, then how to add a title, how to protect against manual changes, and how to change the level of heading, and also how to assign custom style. If the style is not as a heading 1, heading 2, or heading 3, how that additional style can also be included into our table of content. This is what we learned in this assigning styles. You remember we have done this, all the same thing is in. Now the entries tab, this particular tab I am going to teach you next time, because it is a little bit more elaborate, and again applying character styles we will be doing in the next class. We also learned how to give adding colors, the different background tabs, and adding graphics, and how to delete the color, and how to save a table of content, and how to update a table of content. We also learned that if I make any changes to the document, I need to right click and update the table of content by and click on it. Then again, the last part is how to delete a table of content. Once again, if I don't want a table of content, I can simply delete the table of content. So this is what we have learned in this. I'm just undoing it because I'll need it for the next class. So this is what we have learned in how to create a table of content in a document. I hope you have understood this particular table, and as you practice by giving different headings, different levels of headings, then you will be able to understand this concept much more easier. So a level of heading, for example, I'll give you one more example of level of headings. For example, Shrima Group of Institutions may be one heading. Under that, we may have Shrima Vidyalaya and Shrima Balniketan as the second level. We can have secondary, primary and pre-primary as the third level. And all, or we can have different, like under the Shrima Vidyalaya itself, we can have Remedial, Shrima Academy, Shrima Snehadeep as the third level. So this way, we can have different levels, and under, in the same document, we can give different levels of headings and put it as a table of content or an index. So this is the gist of today's chapter. Thank you. So in today's class, we have learned three different tabs, which is the index and table tab, the background tab, and the column tab of this particular table of content. And we learned how to customize our table of content using these three tabs. In our next class, we are going to learn the remaining two tabs, which is the entries tab and the styles tab. And at the end of it, we will be able to clearly customize our table of content. Thank you.